What I want to talk today about with employers is taking a fresh look at arbitration in the workplace. We've had the opportunity for a long time to reach agreements with employees such that we would arbitrate rather than litigate employment-related disputes. But we've generally advised against it because arbitrators are much less predictable than judges. They tend to be ruled more by passion. They really don't understand the at-will doctrine. And so what we've advised clients generally to do is to reach agreement with employees to waive jury trials in connection with employment-related disputes. And that works very well in employment discrimination cases and other cases in which federal judges, without the expense and unpredictability of juries, know the law, and they will relate better to what's different between something being unlawful and unfair in the workplace. But there's been a paradigm that has us advising employers differently, at least with respect to a limited type of case, wage payment and wage hour type cases. This paradigm shift arises because of a Supreme Court decision last year in Epic Systems versus Lewis, in which the Supreme Court in three different cases found that class action waivers between employers and employees in favor of arbitration are always going to be, or in most cases, are going to be fully enforceable. The other element that has moved us in a little different direction is that you have a whole host of plaintiffs' lawyers who are specializing only in wage hour, wage payment type claims. They do this because in every workplace lurks technical violations of either the Fair Labor Standards Act or Indiana wage payment, wage assignment laws. Instances, employees are not paid properly for meeting time, travel time, and other issues related to the Fair Labor Standards Act. Are we classifying our employees correctly, exempt versus non-exempt, particularly because there are a lot of subjective holes that employers can fall into? And are we deducting from employees' wages improperly, even though the employee has authorized it under the technical requirements of the Indiana wage assignment law? These plaintiffs' lawyers are pursuing these cases on a class action basis, because even if the individual claims are very small, the plaintiffs' lawyers can get full attorney's fees if they can win even on one small portion of the case. So these are very expensive cases for employers to litigate. The only winner in the cases are plaintiffs' lawyers. The individual employees have to wait a long time, and they get no more than they would have received had they just pursued an individual type action. So what we're advising employers to do is take a look at a policy that is very much like a sexual harassment policy and tells employees, look, we are not going to permit any improper wage payment or wage deductions for you. And to the extent that you face that, you bring it to our attention, there'll be no retaliation, no manager or supervisor can override us, and we're going to make sure that your issue is promptly and fairly investigated and you get full relief. And in return, if we're unable to resolve the case that way, you're agreeing to arbitrate it. And by arbitrating it, it's an informal procedure whereby you could take the case yourself. It's not going to last a long time, and you don't have the formal elements of a trial and the delay of a trial, and you'll still get the same kind of remedy. And so this, I think, is a very important time for you, the employer, to talk with your employment counsel to determine whether this kind of preventive advice and consideration might be in your best interest.